Hey guys, today I am playing something called the Tekkik pack. And I just want to quickly say this pack is amazing. It's separate to Minecraft, but yeah, it looks like Minecraft everything. It's for free, downloads for free, but you do have to have a Minecraft account to play this. But still, it is amazing. It's not a mod, so you don't need to drag any folders or anything. It's just, you download it, launch it, and bang, you got the game. And what I love about this is it adds a whole lot of mods, and the mods are really good. They're really good mods, like Mo Creatures, for example. And this is just fantastic. It's really, really good. I would suggest it to everybody. It's absolutely fantastic. It doesn't stuff up your other Minecraft. It has nothing to do with your Minecraft. So, and you can play Minecraft whenever you want, and you can play this whenever you want. And what I really like about it is it adds... There's some mods in it that add machines and all different kinds of ores, and it's just a really, really good pack. I love it, and I've been playing a bit of it, but I'm still pretty new at it. It's really hard to get used to it because there's so much ores. It's complicated making machines. It's pretty complicated. If you wanna get like a kind of Minecraft that's more complicated, get this, because this is a very very good brain teaser. So I'm just going now to create a world, and the reason why I'm doing this is because I've been getting some inboxes about Minecraft, and people have been telling me to do some Minecraft. So I was like, okay, I'll do Minecraft, but I'll make it more interesting. I'll do Tekkit Minecraft. So that is what I am doing now. So world name, we don't really need a world name. Tekkit World. We'll name it Tekkit World. So here we'll do survival. Sorry about that. We'll type default, yep. Don't worry about the seed, we'll just get whatever seed we get. So let's create a new world. So it does take a little bit longer to like build the world in the Tekkit launcher, because it has to load all the mods, but that's okay. And the first objectives you have to try and get is you have to try and get rubber. And that is also out of the stuff that comes off trees, the rubber trees. I forgot what it's called. But yeah, we have spawned on kind of forest island. And so like usual in Minecraft, we're going to collect some wood first. And it's good because it doesn't lag that much with the Tekkit launcher, because sometimes when you download mods on Minecraft, sometimes lag, but with this it doesn't lag that much. It might lag for me sometimes because I'm recording, but that's fine. So after you collected your wood, and in the Tekkit pack, they add these kind of trees. These trees, you can't make wood out of them, but with one block you can make 8 sticks out of them. But what you can do is when you start making machines, you can actually make a machine that changes that wood into rubber. So you won't have to worry about those kinds of trees. Just gonna click, cause they're very common, but the trees where you actually get the stuff to make rubber, they're pretty hard to find. So this isn't a good place to stay on. There's none of those rubber trees I was talking about. So I'm gonna move. And a turtle, look, some turtles. Can't punch the turtles because they're kind of blocking. They're in the shell. So, and also in the Tekkit pack, it adds villagers and all other kinds of stuff, and why I said like villagers is because it makes the villagers more for intelligent, and you can sell stuff to them, and you can also get quests off them. So here they have some stuff. I can't get any of it because it's locked. So see, like I said, you can sell stuff and you can buy stuff from them. And I can't talk to that guy, but I can talk to that girl. Oh, and they've got a thing here where they've got some of that stuff there. I don't even know what that is. But yeah, like this is like a random generated house. And yeah, so they're all scattered around the world. And yeah, I like how they put that in, so you can do quests and their villages are more intelligent. Sugarcane. So right now we're looking for a cave, because those are the most highest in all the ores, and we're not seeming to find any caves, any trees. This was a pretty bad place to spawn. Doesn't seem that good. Cave, there we go. So this is the cave. It's very, that down there, lag. A little bit of lag there. Oh, this is interesting also. So this is the cave that I'm going to be mining in, because like I said, caves are the most richest in minerals, and look, there's already iron there. So it sticks, and the first thing I want to make is a pickaxe. And you can die really easily in this game because of mo creatures. There's just so much more enemies, like for rats, and werewolves are the pain in the ass because they take so long to kill and they hit really hard. So now I got my cobblestone pickaxe, and now I can mine this iron. So at the start, in Tekkitcraft, it's just a little bit slow. You have to collect every mineral you see in Tekkitcraft. You can't let any minerals go, or else, because you'll mostly need a lot of ores for your machines, and a lot of them take refined iron, and you're going to need a lot of iron for that, and a lot of them take coal. So you're gonna need a lot of coal also. So this cave is really pretty rich in ores. I'm really liking this cave. The only problem now is rubber trees. I barely can find any rubber trees. But we'll find some. I hope we'll find some. So we don't, we're stuffed. Cause what you do for rubber is you put them on your cables and all that, because the cable, if you don't have rubber on your cables, you actually have a percentage chance of the cables to shock you, and you don't want that to happen to you, or else you just don't want it to happen to you, or else you can die, and then like it's game over. Nah. But usually when I used to, when I play Tekkapack, when I die, I just usually start a whole new game, because all the ores I lose, and I usually always, there's never usually a cave near my spawn point, so I never know where to go, and I just have to start a new game. It's really annoying, but you gotta do what you gotta do. And here we have marble. Not really used for anything. As you can see, there's a lot around, but not really used for anything. And this cave has a lot of iron. Whoa. A lot and a lot of iron. At least we can use this for iron tools and iron armor. And we can also make refined iron just to make this a little bit more better. Just so we can make machines. Because machines are the funnest part of this pack. Just making quarries and, oh, it's all just so fun. Any more? Gonna make sure I don't run into any mobs and die, or else, probably be the end of this series. Don't want that to happen. So, I think that was it in ores. But, so yeah, that had a lot. Oh, wait, that goes down there. Oh. A little bit of lag. I've done a little bit. So a village, I think, just spawned, and that's what made me lag. So, sorry about that. So, that wasn't actually the end of the cave. So, yeah, villagers do spawn near you, and it does lag, because, they have to spawn. But at least I know that there's a village near me now. So, this also has, this, mod also has lumberjack? Is it lumberjack or lumber mill? Lumberjack or lumber mill, and what happens, what the mod does is, when you, hit with an axe, when you hit the, that's cool, look at the, it seems like a tribe, I guess. Like I was saying, when you hit the bottom of the tree with axe, it all falls down. It's really good. Hello. Apple, yay. At least I know that, I've got, like, a, kind of village near me. And now I always have, cactus! You're gonna need, some cactus in this game, because cactus actually, does something in this game. It's amazing, it actually does something. So, population 5. So, can we, who do we sell, this is the vendor. Okay, so sandstone. They need a lot of sandstone. So you can actually I can't take anything out of there. You can actually get your reputation up with villagers and by doing some quests for them, and like here they need sandstone, so like putting sandstone in there. And so then you can do that. And whoa, have some that hasn't rendered up. Yeah, so like I said, that's pretty awkward, but okay. Yeah, like I said, you can do tasks for them, quests, and you could sell stuff to them, and then they will then like sell you houses and all that, and you'll get more quests, and they'll give you money, and it's pretty cool to do all that. And here we have a unicorn. I think it's a unicorn. Maybe it's a horse with a horn. I do not know that, but for now I am going to end episode 1 of Tech It, guys. I hope you like this video. Been episode 1, and yeah, like I said, I hope you like this video. So before I go, I want to kill this zombie. Where'd it go? Oh no, and there's a scorpion. Eat my wooden pickaxe. Oh shit. Stay back. It's gonna poison me. Scorpions actually poison you. So yeah, like I said, my creatures actually makes it a little bit more harder, but that's okay. And before I go, I want to come over here and make a furnace. And on that task, on that note, I'm going to end the video here, guys. Oh, shit. I hope you like this video, and Hope you like it. Oh, they've really run out fast. And, so, die. I don't want to end the video. I don't want to end the video for zombie chasing me. Okay, so I will see you later, guys. Bye, guys.